So, how are you? Welcome to St. Mary Medication British International High School online class. Today, we'll be looking at profits. Don't forget, we talked about capital, and we discussed capital both in layman's definition, the economic view of capital, as well as the accountant's view of what? Capital. So today, we are going to be talking about our profits, how to calculate for profits in a business. And at the end of the day, we are still going to look at turnover, as in how we arrive at turnover, as well as gross profits and net profits. These are all types of profits. So pay attention. And before we start, the first word here is what? Definition of what? Profit. He said in the trading business, two concepts of profit are applicable. These are gross profit and net profit. When we talk about profit in accounting, we have two types of profit. We have the gross profit and the what? And the net profit. It's true the gross profit to be derived what? The net profit. Like as you can see, he said the gross profit simply refers to the excess of the value of sales. That is turnover, the cost of goods sold, before taking other expenses secured in the business into the account. What our definition is trying to tell us is that before you calculate your gross profits, you just forget about other expenses that you incur, maybe lighting, salary, maybe accommodation, or maybe rent, even with salaries and wages, you understand me? These are some of the expenses incurred by the business. So before you calculate your gross profits, you have to worry about those expenses. But if what you do first is that the things that you have in the shop minus it from what you sold so far, then at the end of the day you arrive at what? Gross profit. Before that, talking about what other words, expenses incurred. Then that of the net profit is the excess of all sources of income, sales value plus other income, over all expenses, often called what? Revenue expenditure. As I earlier said, the net profit is derived from here, from the gross profit. How? By the time you in the gross profit, you just calculate your sales. You divide it by what you have in the shop. But if the net profit, you take both sales and all other work expenses incurred during the business or transaction. And then you now arrive at your net profit. That one is basically telling us. Then types and uses of profit, gross profit and net profit. We are going to look at the uses of profit, the usefulness of what? Profit. And also look at how to calculate your gross profit as well as the net profit. First and foremost, sales. This represents the price at which the goods are sold during the period. You know, in our profit and loss account, we always have our sales in our left hand, in our right hand side. The sales represent the price at which all the goods has been sold during the period of the year. That is how much selling all the goods. Let's assume that won't say period of a year. It can be from January 1st to 31st of December. That can be what the period of what? A year. Then we have the net sales. This which constitutes the gross sales less return by customer. That is for you to have your net sales, you minus, don't say less, it means what? Minus. You minus what the customers has returned, which is what? Returns inward. Return inward. We call it what? Return inward. That is what the customer is returning back to you. From here, from the gross sales. That's where you calculate your what? Your net sales. I won't say return outward. That is what you are returning backward to the manufacturer. By so doing, you also want to subtract. But that one is at what? At the left hand side. While the right hand side, you less what? Return in one word by the customers. Then you minus it from your sales. You now have what is forward? The net profit. Then the cost of sales. How do you calculate your cost of sales? This represents the cost price of all the goods that can be calculated as stocks. That is all the goods you have in your shop, in your business. You can ask cost of sales, calculate everything. You understand? No, you need inventory. We have continuous inventory, daily inventory, you understand me? So it can be continuous thing or either daily thing or weekly what? Inventory. This is how you calculate for what? Format of trading accounts for the period. Let's assume that opening stock, that is the things you have in the shop, the amount you use in starting the business. The next thing add what? Purchases. After opening the business with 3,000 naira, you have purchased things of 37,000. Say add purchases. That means you add purchases to what? To your opening stock. You now have what? 52,000 there and then. Less closing stock. Maybe you are giving closing stock in your question as 21,000. So you minus 21,000 from 52,000. Then you now have what? what your cost of sales. Then after that, the gross profit. But before you calculate for the gross profit, let's look for the sales in our question. Let's say the question says is what? 38,000 was of 750. Understand? So 38,000 was 750. Now minus it from your what? Your cost of sales, which is at 1,000. Then you now have 7,750, which will not be your gross profit. So this is how we calculate for gross profit. You see, I have the calculation there. 38,750 minus 31,000. Which we arrive at was 7,750. That will not be your gross profit. Then 38,700, bring it down. We also write 38,700 there under the debit side. Then the net profit. How do you calculate for net profit? The net profit is calculated at the essence of gross profit and the sources of income except sales. That is what we have in our gross profit. That's how we use to calculate for what? For our net profit. But we must not include what? Sales. That's why I said except sales. Overall, the expenses. The differences between the two sides, which is the net profit, is then inserted on the smaller side. That is the left side. So as to mark the two sides what equal. As you can see, these two sides are what equal, which is 8,000. Look at it. Wages and salary. That's expenses incurred by the business. Maybe they have some laborers, they pay wages weekly. Then salary, maybe they have some staff, they pay salary monthly, understanding. Then the amount they arrive at for water, 3,200. Electricity bills, that's also what expenses secured by the business, 500 naira. Bad debts. Bad debts, these are debts that can never incur. That is, let's assume that maybe the customer comes to the shop to get something on his way back, because my allowance letter has died. Understanding, you can never be able to get such money. It's called bad debt. Also record such. And have such debts in our business so that we know how much we lost at the end of the profit year. Understand me? Or maybe a customer bought something from you, not return the money, the customer is nowhere to be found. That's found out with a bad debt. So maybe the bad debt you have in this business is 200 naira. Depreciation, this is the value you want in a product. Let's assume that you have something in the shop to sell, and that thing has been there for like 2-3 years, nobody's coming. Then the customer will now go and ask, okay, let me slap some price. By so doing that, appreciate that reduction in price. Understand? Maybe it's H which will reduce there. Then discounts allowed. Don't say discounts allowed. It's talking about the discount you allow for your customers. Let's assume 10% discount for 100 naira. Understand? We have that 90 naira there. Maybe 10 naira worth discount. So this business had an 850 naira worth, 150 naira worth discount allowed. So we already have the expenses here. So you now come to side. The gross profit. How do you get our gross profit? That is the money we have before our gross calculation. 7,750. Discount received. That is you that is the seller. You are receiving some discount from the supplier. So you put that in what? And the left hand side, which is how much? 120. Interest received. That is the supplier also. So reduce some words of interest. Maybe you have interest at the end of some product that you sold out. Start is 1,000. By the time you add everything together here, you don't have how much there? 3,130. 3,130 minus it from 8,000. That will not be your net profit, which is what? 3,130. You see now? So this is how to calculate for net profit. You minus all the expenses incurred, minus it from what? From other expenses that you received. Then at the end of the day, you now have your net profit. Uses of profit. What do we use profit for? What is the usefulness of profit? Is a profit a reward to entrepreneurs? Who are entrepreneurs? These are the owners of the year. Let's assume that the Emmy has circumvented what? An entrepreneur. She also has what? Some profit. So these are one of the uses of what? Profit is a reward. The reward for profit is what? And for entrepreneur is what? The reward for profit for entrepreneur is what? A reward, sorry. That is the benefit of profit to entrepreneur is what? Reward. You understand me? Four factors of production or economics, don't forget that. Then profit provides funds for finance. With the help of profit in business, one of people to have fun to go on your business or to finance a project that is at hand. Then profit for the long run survival of business. Then if there is profit in the business, that means the business will survive. A situation where one is doing a business, there is no profit. That business will not work. We don't survive for a long run period. Then, profit is useful for the poor people and the government. Yes, the government use profits to take care of other expenditure or economy. Even we as humans, we are individuals. We also need profit, which is money. So these are some of the uses of what? Profits.